why the Lakers out of all the teams in the NBA? Your first chance.
This is the team that gave me the opportunity and show the biggest interest. And for me, it's just, I have like no words to express my my feelings right now. You know, playing for the Lakers and wearing this this jersey that is like one of the most wanted jerseys in the whole world for players to wear. So I really get like speechless when I have to say about the opportunity they gave me.
Said that you knew you wanted to make that jump to the NBA. Why now? Why so?
Well, because I think after I gave a few big steps in Europe, winning some titles and being a successful player in Europe, this was the first year I actually had the chance to get out of contract. I was under contract under the last 6 years, and I have never had the chance to leave Europe, you know, without paying a big buyout. So this was the year I finished contract and I had a real chance to give this jump to the NBA. So I thought this was the perfect scenario, and luckily it happened.
Speaking about that, what is it that you do as a basketball player that makes you perhaps unique, or what is it that you bring?
Well, I think maybe the experience, the ability to control a team on the court without having to score, and just like a being a leader out there, making others better, trying to create for others, and you know, bringing all the experience I had. And I've always been a player that liked to play important games and take responsibility. So I'm here to bring whatever I can to the team, whatever the coach wants from me.
The Lakers have young talent, right? And D'Angelo Russell, Jordan Clarkson, specifically too at that point guard position. Have they talked to you about mentoring those guys? What do you think you can kind of teach them?
Well, this is what I was saying before, you know, maybe I can bring some experience, try to help them, especially on reading situations of game and teaching something they would only learn when they're older, you know, like they'll gain this experience with time and with playing games. Whenever they get older, they'll learn a lot. So they have, you know, many players here that can tutor them, and hopefully I can be one of them.
You remember about that? What do you remember about playing against Kobe back with the national team?
Well, playing against Kobe is just like a challenge, you know, like because he's so competitive, and he's one of those guys that always wants the ball and wants to prove he's better than everyone else. And when you play against him, it's no different than that. So I remember playing in Washington, if I'm not mistaken, against Kobe, and it was funny, you know, because actually, you know, throughout the game, I was guarding him for a little bit, and it's, you know, something different and special. I remember that.
Kobe is someone who likes to demand the ball, you said. He likes to have the ball. And you're a point guard now, and now he's your teammate, and he's demanding the ball. But maybe it's not the right play, and you're trying to control the thing. Have you envisioned that kind of conflict, or how do you resolve it?
Well, I think this is like a situation you have to resolve inside of the court. You know, it's hard for you to predict something like this, but it depends. You know, he's a player that, you know, he's won so many games, and even if it's not the play and he's demanding the ball, I think he's got the responsibility, and he's one of those players that can make it happen. So I think everyone, not only me, would give him the ball and just say, okay, make it happen. And I mean, 90% of the times he'll make it happen. So for us, it's like a privilege to have like a player like this, you know. But I think, I mean, 90% of the times as well, I think he's like a smart player, and he'll know what to do on the court. He's a leader, so it won't be a problem.
Are you looking forward to going up against him again in practice?
Well, we don't play the same position, but eventually, for sure, we're gonna have to guard each other, you know, and like during practice. And I mean, it's gonna be something interesting, and for me, it's gonna be a great experience. And also, learn and get better.
You've admitted defense isn't necessarily one of your strong points. Byron Scott, just being a defensive-minded coach, how do you see that fitting in? Are you trying to continue to improve on that end?
Well, I think a basketball player never stops improving, only if you want to. You know, so I mean, for me, it's just another experience coming in here and try to get better in every single aspect of the game, and especially on defense. I think he's going to push me hard, and I have to push myself, and I will.